Well, there is a new scandal that is surfacing right now surrounding the State Parks Department, this time over a payroll audit. Now, this is the same department that generated headlines last summer after hiding $54 million from the governor's office.
KCRA3's Mike Lurie live at Sutter's Fort in Sacramento with new revelations about improper payments. Mike?
That's right, Kelly. You know, Sutter's Fort is, of course, the place that many parents take their fourth graders to learn a little slice of California state history. But tonight, a very different kind of history lesson involving a financial scandal at the California State Parks Department. Visitors at Sutter's Fort were disappointed today to learn of new abuses at the State Parks Department.
It's a shame that that would happen.
Well, I don't feel it's right, you know, and it's a shame because, you know, we need things like this for heritage to bring our kids up and stuff.
Controller John Chung found hundreds of employees were being overpaid and that managers failed to follow state procedures.
They did not do their job. That's a correction that needs to be immediately enacted, and we need to make sure that there's the proper training in place and that you have the appropriate safeguards.
The controller's audit found $520,000 in improper payments to 203 employees. There was no approval and no documentation for extra compensation. The controller said the lack of protocols invites the abuse of public funds. And today, I questioned State Parks about it. How did this happen?
I wish I knew that. I'd have to get into the mind of the people that did this. I think there were just lax controls in place. And in some cases, people ignored policy that was in place.
State Parks is already making changes with a new executive team.
Beyond that, there are procedures and safeguards and new rules and policies put in place to make sure this doesn't happen again.
The real challenge now will be to restore the public's confidence.
They do need to look at it and see what's going on, but I have a lot of trust in our state park system.
Well, the former director of State Parks, Ruth Coleman, resigned last summer following all those abuses. In the meantime, there is a new executive team in place, a team that says it is committed to the audit. We'll follow the recommendations and make sure that, again, this doesn't happen one more time. Reporting live from Sutter's Fort, Mike Lurie, KCRA 3 reports.
So, Mike, you mentioned that some of the park workers there were overpaid. So are there going to be any repercussions for that? Do they have to pay the money back?
Yeah, there will be repercussions. The state controller, John Chung, says he's very adamant that there has to be recompensation on that. He's going to ask the State Parks Department to make sure that money gets paid. He says he'll also be actively monitoring the department to make sure that happens.
Mike Lurie reporting in Sacramento for us tonight. Thank you.